Go back to your first love. My city, oh my side. Ah, that must have been a sidebar. But anyway, Jesus. And he left Judea. And he said, I must need go through Samaritan. Then cometh he in a city of Samaritan, which is called Sychar. He came to the place where they said that there was a falsehood there. And he came to the place where there was drunkenness there. But oh my God, I feel God. And he came to that place, glory to God. My God, my Savior, near to the parcel of the ground that Jacob gave to his son Joseph. Now Joseph's well was there. Jesus, therefore, being weary with his journey, sat thus on the well. And it was about the sixth hour. That means it was noontime. Jesus was weary. He was, oh my gosh, when you get weary. And also he was thirsty, because it goes on down when he said, he asked the Samaritan. He said, therefore cometh a woman, a Samaritan, to draw water. And Jesus said unto her, give me drink. I want to set this thing up here. See, first of all, you got Jesus. He's tired from his journey. And not only that, y'all can have a seat. Y'all can have a seat. Y'all good. He was tired from his journey. But then he comes to the well because he was thirsty. You know, anybody been thirsty? Because if you become thirsty, you become dehydrated. And sometimes you become confused, glory to God. That's in the natural. And then you become weak, glory to God. But if you become thirsty in the spiritual realm and you're not being fed, good God from Zion, the Bible says a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. Yeah. So we find that. And one thing I like about in this particular text, see, I'm setting the foundation, but we're gonna go somewhere in a minute. But what happened here is that Jesus, he forgot about himself. And he saw the woman at the well. And after a while, when she became confused about what he was asking for, because many times she came to the well, and there was something else at the well. There was always a man at the well trying to pick up. So when the real man come, women, huh? When the real man come, we can identify when it comes, because we're so used to the falsehood coming to the well.
Come on now. Come on. Come on. Come on.
Yeah. Yeah. So now she began to ask a question. Yeah, we're going to go deeper than that, because I'm going to help you understand what the well represents in this chapter. And what she meant, what she was saying, that my well is deep. You're going to find out in a minute. So now, where am I? He said, give me drink. Then said the woman of Samaritan unto him, now it is that thou, being a Jew, ask drink of me, which am I a woman of Samaritan? For the Jews have no dealing with the Samaritans. So, and Jesus answered and said unto her, if thou knew it, the gift of God, and who it is that said to thee, give me to drink, thou wouldst have asked of him, and he would have given thee living water. See, here it is. Jesus began to ask for something to drink. And then the woman of God went over to the sideboard and said, wait a minute. You being a Jew, you asking me, for a Samaritan woman, for something to drink. Because they didn't have any interaction with one another. They didn't associate with one another. They weren't in the same clique, glory to God. So now she is confused, because the man came asking for a drink. And then he, in other words, he didn't have a drink. And then he began to offer her a drink. That is confusing. So now she said, wait a minute now. And this is the point I like. The woman said unto him, sir, thou hast nothing to draw with, and the well is deep, from which thou hast thy living water. Oh my God, Savior. So now we come to the part where she's telling Jesus, because she's seeing the picture in the natural. But tell somebody, get in the spirit of God. So she's telling him that you have nothing to draw with, because she didn't see a bucket in front of him, glory to God, that can go down into the well, glory to God, and can pull up some water. And then she began to tell Jesus, now, you got nothing to draw with, and my well is deep.
Oh, Lord.
Let me go to 2 Peter, and let me tell you what the wells represent. And then you begin to understand what she was saying about her well was deep, glory to God. Because you know how he said, I'm well. Glory to God. But the Bible says that My thoughts are like whales. We find that 2 Peter. We gonna roll in a minute. We gonna roll in a minute.
Quite often. Glory to Jesus.
Amen. 2 Peter chapter 2. We gonna start at verse 12 and go on up to verse 17.